I marvel at how empires fall, especially the empires that imploded. They weren't attacked, really. They weren't besieged, like in Constantinople for hundreds of years. The Eastern Roman Empire got smaller, 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 till it just was a tiny city-state of Constantinople, but they held out. But you could see why they would fall after a while, I mean, after hundreds of years of being besieged. Egypt, Rome, the Soviet Union, just imploded, gone. And what seems that they all have in common is that they really became godless. You know, they started out sort of looking to God, but then they just, it all collapsed. Pope Benedict, I think wisely, sees our church at a time or in an age, possibly when Western civilization is sort of at that brink. Again, it's not like we haven't seen it before. It's distressing to all of us because we're participants in it. But I think Pope Benedict sees that the church kind of finds itself at a time in history which is repeating itself once more. And thus, he's taking his cues or sort of giving us direction as if we were the Christians of the first century. And let us see how the early Christians dealt with a time in which they could see their world sort of passing by, but very much with faith in God, that the kingdom of God was very much at hand. I think we can see that today. For many, it's exceptionally distressing because they sort of want to hold on to what they can. It's like, okay, let's hold on to this. It's sort of sad. It's like we can see it going like sand through our hands, and we really can't save it. In some ways, you wonder, is it worth saving? What is important? And I think many of us recognize what is important is right relationship with God. That's what the Lord wanted of the Ninevites. That's what Jesus wants of us. Right relationship with God. The Ninevites were saved because they were warned and they paused, and so amazing, isn't it? Not just the people fasted, the animals fasted too. They wouldn't even feed the animals enough. We have to suffer, you have to suffer. Everybody was fasting. People were focused on their sinfulness. We are not evil. I don't think we could be coming to Mass and be evil, but we certainly have to focus ourselves, because the allure to the culture is so strong that we're those frogs in the hot tub. They're just, and the temperature gets hotter and hotter and hotter, and we're just lounging around, and it's getting hotter and hotter. They have no sense what to get out of the water until they boil. And we can be that way in the culture, that we think, I can handle it, I'm strong enough. And it's not as though we should, and in many churches, they want to literally remove themselves from the culture. It's not our prerogative. That's not our vocation. We're not called to be hermits, and we're not called to walk away. The Lord has planted us within this culture to be a leaven, to change it. If we are of God, we are suffering. And we will continue to suffer. We'll be mocked at, we'll be chastised. And time is coming, if not already, we'll be put in prison. And history does repeat itself. With those who stand up for the faith, for life, for what God wants, they'll be put to death. Lord, do not put us to the test. But let us ourselves be disposed well. We will not be useful servants to God in sort of a lukewarm, lackadaisical life. We have to go to confession, and we have to acknowledge our sinfulness. I point out sort of the sin out there, but we must look at the sin in ourselves. We must purge ourselves of our sinfulness. It's so easy to point out the sin out there, and there's so much, but that gives us no excuse or right to neglect our own life, our own state. We must reflect on our sinfulness, not my spouse, my children, my parents, our sinfulness. And we sin. We sin because we're not always focused on the Lord. And how can we be a leaven in the culture if we do not acknowledge our own sinfulness, in which we conquer our pride and our arrogance, and we think, I say my prayers, look how holy I am. Ooh. That just defies all that we've tried to do in getting close to God. He takes the humble, he takes the lowly, and he raises them up. How to become so humble? How to become so lowly? I don't know. But I think that's our vocation, because then he will raise us up. He will use us then. But we have to be useful. But he has to find something useful in us. So there has to be a desire, a will on our part to be at his service, at his beck and call. Not my will, Lord. Your will be done. Let us stand and pray.